Hello everybody, welcome to this course on Embedded Systems Design, Verification and Test. I am Arnab Sarkar, an Associate Professor with the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at the Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati. There will be two other instructors in this course along with me, Professor Jatindra Kumar Deka and Dr. Santosh Biswas, also with the Department of CSE at IIT Guwahati. So, what will we be dealing with in this course? Embedded systems. An embedded system can be described as a computing system which is part of a larger physical system. Examples of embedded systems range from simple elevator controllers, controllers in our washing machines, to complex avionics navigation control systems, anti-lock braking systems in a car, control systems in nuclear reactors, etc. Unlike a general purpose computer system, embedded systems are typically designed for specific functionalities, often with stringent performance objectives and constraints related to real time accuracy, the area it takes, power consumed, cost, etc. Their implementations may include both software and hardware components and may necessitate integration with sensors and actuators. The increase in complexity of modern embedded systems mandates automation in their design. Given a system which we intend to implement, the design process majorly evolves through distinct but often overlapping and iterative phases, which include modeling and design, verification and validation, and testing. I will be taking up the modeling and design part. Verification and validation will be taken up by Professor Deka, and Dr. Biswas will take up the testing part. The course will systematically cover all these topics so that the student gains an end-to-end understanding of the overall embedded systems design process. To elaborate a bit more, so we look into the phases, modeling and design, verification and validation and testing in a bit more detail. Modeling may be regarded as a systematic specification of the intended system behavior. That is, it tells what the system should do. Models should mathematically capture both static properties and dynamic properties of the system at a desired level of abstraction so as to allow systematic analysis. Here, static properties would mean the distinct system states, and dynamic properties would tell us how state changes occur over time. For example, let us consider that we want to model an embedded system which keeps track of the number of cars in a parking lot at any given time. The entry and exit of the parking lot has sensors to detect the entry and exit of cars. In a simple model for the system, each state could represent the distinct number of cars in the parking lot, and to model changes, state changes, and the state changes would be modeled by the cars, new cars entering into the parking lot and existing cars departing from the parking lot. So, state changes will be determined by new cars entering and existing cars departing from the parking lot, and the distinct states will be the number of cars at any given time. After modeling comes design. Given the model based logical depiction of a system along with estimates on performance and resource requirements of various components, we embark onto the design phase, which derives appropriate structural representations and implementation methodologies corresponding to the specified behavior. That is, it tells how a system shall do what it should do. So, what it should do was told in the modeling phase, and how it should do, that is, deriving structural representations, is obtained in the design phase. Design involves consideration of both hardware and software to take care of different conflicting verticals such as performance, cost, flexibility, energy dissipation, etc. An overall system which includes both hardware and software components must consider various issues and apply appropriate mechanisms such that end-to-end performance objectives are always satisfied. For example, important issues may include obtaining execution time estimates of different components and analyzing interferences between their execution from both the external environment and other co-executing components. Okay. So, these issues are typically handled through mechanisms such as the use of more predictable artifacts like compiler controlled memories and employment of appropriate scheduling techniques at various levels. Overviews of these design strategies will be discussed in this course. After design comes verification of the design. This phase may be considered to be the process of gaining a deeper insight or deeper understanding of a system through dissection. The objective is to ensure design correctness. Verification is the process of determining whether a system satisfies a given property of interest. For example, given that data from a brake pedal sensor arrives every 100 milliseconds, can we guarantee the property that the brake controller will always be able to produce processed actuation outputs every 100 milliseconds? So that the need to buffer input sensor data may be avoided. The course introduces formal verification method to verify design correctness of a system. In formal verification, we use an abstract mathematical model of the system to be checked and describe the desired behavioral properties with precise mathematical rigor. Lastly, testing of embedded systems is introduced. Testing is the systematic process of checking whether the prototyped or manufactured device actually performs the required behavior. Testing is entirely different from verification. While verification checks the correctness of a design, testing checks whether the manufactured system is a correct implementation of the design. So, testing is a post-implementation exercise. Last part of the course will introduce the challenges faced by the tester and the process of testing the system. So, welcome again to this course. We look forward to your active participation and sincerity.